This is their newest Forever Frawl. I will save the swatches. Oh no, not in the tattoo folder. Sheesh. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. This video series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is listed down in the description box, as is the community playlist that she created. My sources are down there. The products I'm going to mention are down there. And I think that's going to be it. Maybe if I... Yeah, discount codes are there. And if I have room left after today's video, I will list the makeup as well. But I have quite a lot to talk about. So I don't know if I'm able to list this. It is done with the Makeup Obsession LA Dreams palette though. I have... this is the last look of the video. I have filmed a multiple looks video. I'm going to film an eye swatch video as well. So... those two videos are coming. I don't know if I will be able to do it this week. It's probably next week though. I'm not sure. Just if you want to know my thoughts and how I created this look and all the rest, just make sure that you have hit that red subscribe button and the bell. I kind of do want to introduce another member to the family. You like? This is the No Drama Llama. Because here on my channel there's no drama. Because I'm dramatic enough. So yeah, I'm all the drama that you need. But I got it from my best friend. And she has one as well. Or she has actually two. And I got one as well. And I thought this one would live here upstairs with me. Because yeah, I kind of removed stuff there. As you may have seen. Okay, let's kind of open up Instagram. What site do I want to go to today? Setup. So I'm here. So I can put the pictures up there. Guys, I have so much. Let's kind of start with... shall I start with an update? Yeah, let's start with an update. And that's actually this. This is from Miali Beauty. And I have mentioned it last week. But I only had pictures that I was filming it of one palette. That was the Yasmin palette. That's the one that you see with the green and the flowers on it. It's so pretty. But she's also releasing Yaya and Ayubia. Wait, I need to see. Yeah, Ayubia. I have... all three palettes now, and in case you are not aware, Miali Beauty was Blush Tribe. She has rebranded, and this is what she's coming out with. These are the first three palettes that she's going to launch. So you see here the swatches of the Yasmin palette. Oh, it looks so pretty, guys. So pretty. Then underneath that you will see the swatches from the Ayubia palette, which looks similar, but they are not. This is more along the lines of a rainbow palette. And the Yasmin is still also kind of a rainbow palette, but with a little bit more, I don't know, those funky greeny shades in there. And then the last one that is in the first release is the Yaya palette. And that one is brown with green and orange. And my two favorites, I love them all, but my two favorites are the Yasmin and the Yaya. Oh. However, it's not all she's releasing, because she's also releasing an eye primer. Just so you know, I'm very, very interested to see the eye primer. And then she is also releasing this. I don't know if this is... I think this is meant to go in the same release, but I'm not sure. And this is a collaboration between Miali Beauty and Rex Bella. Oh, Rekan is her name. And she is a makeup artist from London in the UK. And from my understanding, these are the shades that she uses herself a lot. It looks really pretty. I don't really know if it is my color story per se, but I do think it's a really pretty... palette, and that artwork, mwah, so pretty. So that was the update from Miali Beauty, and I'm definitely going to get the Yasmin palette. And after that, we shall see. I know that she wants to release them in July, so in this month. If I have any more information, I will update you guys on it. But as of yet, this is all I know. Okay, let's next go to some more releases. What did I have here? Yes, this is the Book of Divination from Spellbound Beauty Co. It contains 15 shades, 3 pressed glitters, 3 metallics and 9 mattes. It's available for purchase and it retails for $20 to $50 American dollars. I like the aesthetic of this. I like it. It's not, the color story does not really, is not for me, but I did want to mention it because, yeah, it's an indie brand that I hadn't heard of before and I love finding new indie brands. So yeah, then the next thing I'm going to talk about is Rituel de Ville, or is it Rituel de Ville? I don't know. Let's be fancy. This is the Chimera Metamorphic Highlighter. It's available now for a whopping $32. They are donating 100% of the profits of this highlighter to organizations advancing the ideals of liberty and justice for all by working to end mass incarceration, discriminatory sentences. I feel like I'm not pronouncing that correctly, but you know what I mean. And wrongful convictions. So that is an amazing cause. Yeah, it looks really pretty though. Let's see, it's one. The Chimera, the Enchantress, the High Priestess, the Sorcerer, and the Siren. So there are 4? Okay, so the shade is new. It's a limited edition shade, and that's the shade Chimera, and it is swatched on the top. And then you get Enchantress, High Priestess, Sorcerer, and Siren. So those are the normal shades, but Chimera is a new limited edition shade, I think. That pink one looks gorgeous, but while I love the cause, I'm not going to pay $32 for a highlighter, just saying. It's just not in my price range. So yeah, let's next go to Pinky Rose Cosmetics. And I have not heard anyone talk about it as I am filming this. This is the new Pump That Bass collection. And Bass is in base collection. Pump That Bass collection. Bass, base, whatever. It says here, consider this product as the most versatile base stick. We named our collection Pump That Bass, bass, whatever. It's totally a genre vibe. It is online already and it retails for $10 each, I believe. It intensifies an eyeshadow to give it that boom. It can be used on the lips, it can be used as an eyeliner, can be used to color your lashes, and you can do a full face with this collection. And it is basically sticks. Some kind of remind me of eyeshadow based sticks, but then you have different colors, and I actually really like this concept. I like the format as well. I like it. So they retail for $10 each and you get 90 for the full set. I like it. I like the colors that are in here. I like the fact that you can use them everywhere. You know, I have been known to use an eye pencil and as a lip pencil and vice versa. And I think, yeah, different color bases. Yeah, I like this. I like it, and I like the whole aesthetic as well with the outer packaging. I like it. Let me know if you have heard of this. Let me know if you have tried it. Let me know down in the comment section. Let's next go to Makeup Revolution, because I saw this on the site. This is their newest Forever Flawless Spirituality Palette. The color story is pretty neutral. Still, it looks pretty, but that outside, ooh, it's very, very pretty. Now, I have here their Pride palette that's also in a tin. I haven't used it yet because I haven't gotten around to it. This looks very, very pretty. I don't know if it is specifically for me, but I do see it appeal to a lot of people. It retails for £12, €12 or $15. And then the next thing that we have is a bunch of stuff from Makeup Obsession, because they have released some small 9-pan eyeshadow palettes, monochromatic palettes. You get Keep It Fresh is a minty one, Ocean Blues is blue, then Sweet Like Candy is a purpley one, Pretty in Pink, Squeeze Me, Sunshine. You get a load of, I really like these actually. They kind of look like the ones from Colourpop. Yeah, Colourpop is basically one of the first who really started this. But I do like these. I like the pinky one, I like the purpley one, I even like the orangey one, you know. And for me, this is more accessible. I really, really love the Makeup Obsession formula, the normal formula that they have. And I would actually love to try one of these as well, just to see if the formula is the same. Let me know if you have tried one of these. Let me tell you what they retail for. They retail for £5, €6 or $7. Really, that's just... I think I'm gonna need me to get me one of these. Okay, the next palette that they have released is the... let's see, what is this one called? This is a bigger palette. It's Nude is a New Nude. Is that the one? No. Honey. Oh, Golden Honey. So the bigger palette is called Golden Honey. It contains a rich mix of amber, chocolate and gold shades in a range of buttery shimmers and pigmented mattes. The silky textures will melt into the lids, blah, 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 blah. It retails for £10, €11 or 15... No, €11 or €15. Yeah, and then the other one is the New Nude. It's 9 shades and it retails for £6, €7 or €9. That is basically... Is it specifically for me? Not really. But that's not all they released, because they have released the Makeup Obsession Bronze Collection. It is the palette. The palettes are in that launch. It's basically their summer collection, I think. So you have the two palettes that I just mentioned. Then you get body shimmers. Well, you see everything. You get a bunch. I'm not really... Yeah, no. Maybe if they had a bronzing stick, but then in a matte format, I would be interested. But it's not specifically for me. Although maybe that Nudes palette looks pretty. I think I'm going to skip this. But I did want to mention it to you anyway. The next thing is from NYX Cosmetics. There are new Epic Wear Liner Sticks. They are waterproof, transferproof, fadeproof. And they come in 24 shades. They are available at NYXcosmetics.com. I don't really know if they are available in the Netherlands just yet. I have no idea. But yeah, I really like eye pencils. Do I have any eye pencils from NYX? Yeah, I have one. But the one that I actually want, the gold one, is currently constantly sold out. But there are some shades here that are really, really pretty. So I'm very interested in this pencil line. Now, in the Netherlands, Douglas sells NYX, but also Boozy Shop sells NYX. Just so you know. Okay, next is from Ace of Hearts Cosmetics LLC. Okay, Ace of Hearts, that's what it's called. And this is the full reveal of the Donde Vengo eyeshadow palette. It has launched already. So the palette launched and 4 glosses launched. This looks really cute, guys. Yeah, this looks like a fun color story. Do I know what it retails for? Of course not. No, I don't know what it retails for, and I have too much to talk about to go and spend time finding out. I will leave their site down below in the description box. It looks pretty. Yeah, I just wish that kind of brands would list their pricing in the post. But yeah, it's a warmer toned palette. But yeah, I like the color store. What can I say? If you have tried a brand, let me know. The next thing is the new summer release from Ofra. And it is the Summer Edit Pro palette and the Sweet Electric MIDI palette available now. I also don't really know what it retails for, because it doesn't say so here, but it's probably too expensive for me. Yeah, guys, this is not for me. This is no. It's not my style, it's not for me, but I did want to mention it to you anyway. I have complexion products from Ofra. I have the Samantha March collection, the blush and the bronzer from that line. And I have the All of the Lights highlighter from Ofra. I really like those formulas. I've never tried their eyeshadow. I also like their lippies. But yeah, if you have tried this, let me know how the quality is. I know that some do like the over eyeshadow formula and others do not. I have no opinion whatsoever. Next is from Sumptuous Lashes. It is the Made You Look eyeshadow palette. I think it's available now as you are seeing this. I don't know. It's a combination of mattes and shimmers, I believe, but I cannot see because it's not a picture. It is maybe there's a picture here. No, it's not a picture. It's a movie, so I don't really know if there are pressed glitters in here or just shimmers and mattes. I have no idea. The color story does look cute, You get some neutral shades, you get some colorful shades. Yeah, it looks cute. I will obviously leave all the info down below. Next is Ouija Cosmetics. This is a sneak peek of their official Ouija palette. It will launch August the 1st, but pre-orders will be available from July the 10th and onward. I like this. That's it. I like this. I think this is a very nice fall palette. I like the color story of this. I don't know anymore. I don't know what it retails for or what it will retail for. I have no idea. But I like the vibe of this brand. I will leave their information down below. And I really like the color story of this. So if I know any more, if I have more information, I will let you know in due time. Okay, what is next for me? Ah yes, this. This is the latest palette from Lucky Bunny Cosmetics. This is the Greed. And I know she's doing 7 Deadly Sins. I have the Envy palette, her first palette. The videos are up on that. Are they not? Yes, the videos are up on that. I will link them underneath the cards. This is her latest palette and I have already ordered it. So it is on its way to me. I think there is one repeat shade in here. Yeah, the shade Lola was also in the other palette. I don't know if I am particularly fond of a lot of repeat shades, but I do think that it complements this palette color story wise. So I cannot wait to get it. And if it is the same as the last time, I should have it in about 2 weeks, I think. Depending on how well everything goes. Yeah, I cannot wait to try this palette, to try this formula, to see if it is different than the last one. It's probably the same, although these purples can be a little bit harder to formulate, but darker greens and especially bluer greens also. So I'm very curious to see this palette in real life. When I have it, you betcha I'm going to do 3 looks and an eye swatch and a review video and all that goodness. So yeah, okay, let's next go to this. This is from Makeup Geek Cosmetics. These are the new soft focus colors. You get a light sage green. That one is very pretty. Yeah, I love mints. I love that blue. I kind of like them all. Although I think that the shade Bellini and Peach Smoothie, the last two shades, are one. The Bellini is a sweet apricot, and then the Peach Smoothie is a light soft peach. I don't think there will be a lot of difference if you put them on your eye. But I do really like the colors of these. Yeah, I like pastels. Can I say, do I need them? No. Will I get them? Probably not. But I did want to mention them. And they look pretty. Let's see. They are, say, $5.49 each. So that's not too bad, I think. Let me know if you have tried them. The next I'm going to talk about is the Crow and Pebble. I mentioned this a few weeks or maybe even a month back that she was working on colored... what are they called again? Lip balms, tinted lip balms. And here you see them. You see the shades. They all have names as well. They are available already. And I do have a referral code down in the description box that you can use if you want to save some money. I earn store credit. So yeah, that is basically it. There are some shades in here that look really pretty though. The top two, but also, yeah, the middle row looks really pretty. And then, what's it called? The bottom, is it called Skia? Yeah, that one looks really pretty as well. The collection is inspired by ghost and spirit folklore and literature from around the world, since they are just a ghost of color. Each name refers to a different story or particular ghost. That is so cool. Of course I like the Jack of the Lantern. Of course I do. Okay, and they are based in the UK. They have a bunch of stuff. They have eyeshadows. I have some loose eyeshadows. They have basically a whole complexion product thingamajiggy. Go check them out. The next is from Makeup Maniacs Cosmetics. This is the brand new collection. It's the candy collection, I think. It's a brush set and it is an eyeshadow palette. The eyeshadow palette looks cute. The whole collection retails for $70, I think. Because that is what it says here. So, let's check out the eyeshadow palette. Yeah, it's colorful, neutral. I like the mix. I like the mix in here. I like the palette. Yeah, it looks pretty. Let me know if you have tried it. Let's next go to Kylie Cosmetics because they have launched their new bronzer sticks. And the reason that I wanted to mention this is because I'm interested. They retail for 16 bucks. I have a bronzing stick here that is my only bronzing stick that I have been using for, I think, almost a year, and I have still a bit like this left. So I don't think this is a bad price at all, depending on how much you get. But you get, let's see, you get a light, medium tan, and then a deep dark. So the light is a light golden bronze. Then the light medium is a cool taupe. The medium is a neutral bronze. Tan is a warm tan bronze. Deep is a deep neutral bronze. And then deep dark is a dark, deep neutral bronze. Dark, deep. So yeah, I have no idea which shade I should get then. I think actually the neutral bronze, the medium. I think. I don't know if I will though, because I want to finish the bronzing stick that I have first. But let me know if you have tried this and how the formula is. Let's next go to this from Shop Violet Wash. That's new. Shop Violet Wash, yes. They have launched their Sakura Eyeshadow and Pressed Pigment Palette. It is inspired by cherry blossoms. And yeah, it looks pretty. I love pink eyeshadow. So yeah, and I love to combine pink and gold. I also love to combine pink and gray. I love pink eyeshadows. So I do like this palette. I have never tried anything from Violet Wash. I don't know if it retails, if it warrants the $42 price. It is a bigger palette. Let me know if you have tried this, if it is pretty, if it is worth the money. I don't know, but it does look really pretty. Just saying. Okay, the next one is from Queen KM Cosmetics. I think. Yeah, and it is their first ever custom limited edition eyeshadow palette. It is called Abducted. It has 9 shades and a mirror, and it is coming soon. And this is from Indie Makeup Hotspot. Yeah, I like it. Oh, I also have swatches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is it all shimmers? I will save the swatches. Oh no, not in the tattoo folder. Sheesh. It looks that they are shimmers and satins, but I could be mistaken. That is what it looks like when I see them swatched on the arm, but I am actually not sure. It does look pretty though. No pressed glitters as far as I can see, so yay. I don't know. Yeah, it looks to be satins and a shimmer. But I do like the color story. I don't have any more information, I think. It says coming soon, I don't know. So let me know if you know of the brand and if you are excited. Next is from VE Cosmetics. Oh, this should have gone in the beginning, I think. Yeah, because this is the reveal of their latest duochrome eyeshadow palette. It's a very limited edition because they have 50 available right now. However, if there is a higher demand, she will make more. So if you want this, go check it out and order. Or I think if it is sold out, you can wait for the restock. I don't know if it is sold out. So yeah, it's the Alchemist palette. It doesn't say that it has been sold out already. It's all duochrome shades and it looks very, very pretty. I think there are some very, very cute shades in here. The top row is a little bit hard to see because of, yeah, it's harder to see. You see the clip playing. They look very pretty, guys. Yeah, so it retails for £40 currently. And yeah, let me know if you are excited. Maybe you have even ordered it. If you have, let me know. Let's next go to... what do I have? Oh yeah, I was not done with VE Cosmetics. because she also has new lipstick shades. Yes. The... Um, So that those are the ones that you see here. So you get two new unicorn goo shades in mint and in gray. I think those two are the bottom ones. Yes, and then you get two liquid moisture lipsticks in a kiwi fruit green and red cabbage purple. Yeah, they look pretty. I have a few of her matte formulas, three of her matte formula. I like them. They are not overly drying. I do want a lip mask underneath, but yeah, I haven't tried this lipstick formula yet though. Okay, let's next go to, is it Beauty by Christina? Let's see. Wink Beauty. Yeah, okay, so it is called Wink Beauty, and this is the first makeup palette. It is the Bubblicious eyeshadow palette, and it retails for $24. It is available now. It looks cute. It looks like, I cannot even say a half colorful, half neutral, because you get a few neutral browns in here and the rest are colors. I think this looks like a very cute palette, and I get a bubblegum vibe here. Yeah. I don't know, I get the Bubblicious reference. I like it, I like the palette, and I don't think it is too expensive either. I think she's based in the US, and yeah, shipping from the US to me now is a nightmare, so just saying. But it does look really, really pretty. Let me know if you have tried it down below. Yes, this is Dime Cosmetics, and this is the Samarita eyeshadow palette. It's available now for purchase, and it retails for $25. This looks like a fun, bright palette. I can see this being a companion palette for a lot of people. I can see a lot of people struggling with this color story. But I can also see it as a standalone palette. I think it's a cute palette, guys. Is it all matte? I don't know if it is an all matte palette. I think it is, but I'm not sure. Do I have the swatches here? I don't know if it is an all matte palette, because it looks to be that... Let me save this. Swatch. Magini. It looks to be like the purple and the lightest of the blue have a little bit of a shimmer in it. I don't know, but I do like the color story. Okay, let's next go to... Was this... Am I skipping one? No. We are almost done. Let's next go to 90s Baby Cosmetics, because this is the new palette, Betty's Diner. And it is taking it back to the 60s. It features 15 shades, including mattes, shimmers and glitters. And that is it. Yeah, I have a code here that's 90s baby, but I don't know if it is still valid. I will leave it down in the description box. I like the color story. I wish there were no pressed glitters in here, but I do really like the color story. I think there are... I don't know how many press glitters are in here though. But I do like the color story. Let me know if you have tried the palette, because it's available already. And how the quality is. I do like the vibe though. I just could have done without the press glitter. But that is me. And then the last thing I'm going to mention in today's video is the new collection from Nabla. This is... What you get? You get a quad with pressed glitters in them. You get skin bronzing in 4 shades, skin glazing in 2 shades. You get lip glosses in 6 shades, and you get a new Cupid's Arrow, which is a multifunctional pencil in black. I know that Angelica Nykvist has already reviewed this collection. I will leave her channel down in the description box. It looks pretty. I do have to say that I'm not really into the shimmery bronzers at the moment. I don't know why per se, but I'm just not. Those skin glazes do look very pretty, because I do like a shimmery blush. But I have not tried... The only thing I tried from Nabla is their highlighter brush, I think. Was that the only thing? Did I also try a concealer? Or was that Jouer? I don't remember. No, that was Nabla, I think. I haven't really tried anything from them yet. I will... But not just yet. Let me give you prices real quick before we end the video. The glitter palette retails for €24. If you don't know, Nabla is a European-based indie brand. The bronzers, €22 each. The skin glaze, also €22 each. Then lip gloss in 6 shades for, say, €14 each. 10 cents difference. And then the pencil, the Cupid's arrow for say 16 euros. So yeah, I think that's it. I think that is everything that I wanted to talk about. Let me move my mic back to the center as well. That was everything, guys. I had a lot. Phew. Yeah, a lot is coming out. There are. I find myself, I don't know, talking less and less about mainstream brands because, to be quite frank, mainstream brands are kind of boring right about now. So yeah, the indie brands are popping up left and right, and maybe I don't know what is happening, but I see more indie releases than mainstream releases. So yeah, that is basically what I am going to talk about then. If you think that I have missed anything, go follow me on Instagram and tag me in the things that you want me to talk about. Thank you so much to those of you who have tagged me, and this is going to be it for me. Let me know down below your thoughts on my finds, and yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.